Hey YouTube, Martian Colonist here. To celebrate the successful landing last week of Philae on Comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko by the European Space Agency, I'm going to show you how to make your very own comet. To make your own comet, you will need
some water, a bowl with some plastic bags, some cloths, a pair of gloves, a pair of plastic cups, Worcester sauce, ammonia, a hammer or mallet, some soil and mud, and finally some dry ice.
Okay, let's get started then. So as I'm sure many of you know, we now believe that comets are responsible for bringing much of the water that makes up the oceans of our home planet. So the very first thing you're going to add is some water. So get your plastic cups and you're going to add 2 cups of water to your mixture. So that's one. And we're going to be putting all of these into the plastic bag inside the bowl, which is our reaction chamber. Great! However, we know that comets aren't just made of ice. There's rock on them. And so to simulate that, we're going to add next the soil and the mud, because comets are effectively like muddy snowballs. So just get a small spoon and add, say, 2 or 3 teaspoons worth of soil. Make sure to give it a stir after each step. Great! Next, it wasn't just water that comets brought to the primordial Earth. There are many scientists who believe that it actually brought the very building blocks of life. So to simulate that, we're going to add some hydrocarbons to our mix, and that's where the Worcester sauce comes in. So take your Worcester sauce and just put in a few sprinkles or so. Just like that. And don't forget to give it a stir after each ingredient that you add. Great. And now you can take a break and smell your mixture. And you'll be able to smell the kind of semi-pleasant Worcester sauce type smell. And because we're scientists, and we're impartial and we're balanced, we can't have something that smells nice. So we're going to have to add something that smells foul. And this is where the ammonia, NH3, comes in. And that was a terrible justification, but the fact remains there is a lot of ammonia in comets. So let's add a few ammonia crystals. Ammonia is used in, say, fertilizer, for example. There we go. Excellent. We're nearly there now. So, now we need to add our final key ingredient. Because although we have most of the ingredients of what a comet is actually made of, we need to simulate the conditions in which they exist, namely the freezing cold temperatures in the deep vacuum of space. So for this, we have the dry ice, which is at a temperature of minus 78 degrees Celsius. And if you don't happen to have your own dry ice, I'll post a link to some videos below showing you how to make one from a common fire extinguisher. It's pretty easy. Now, because of the cold temperature, make sure to wear safety. You could wear safety goggles, but definitely make sure you wear gloves for this part. So just like the water, we're going to add 2 cups of this. And what we're going to do is, in order to make sure that the comet isn't too clumpy, we're going to add 2 cups of the dry ice onto the 2 cloths. We're then going to cover up the dry ice and use the mallet to smash it until we have an even powder, which we'll then add to our mix. So here is the first bit of dry ice, which I've added to the cloth. And we're going to use a little bit more on that. This is the second bit. Great. And just so that we don't spray it everywhere, I'm going to put an additional cloth on top of the dry ice for when we start crushing it with the mallet. So, we get our handy little Thor's hammer here, and you start to crush it evenly. Every now and then you can pause to take a look at it. Still got a work left here, not quite done yet. So once you think you're done, lay down the mallet, and now this is the part where we're going to have to go very fast for this part. Because the second that I put the dry ice in, it's going to start rapidly freezing the other ingredients. And so just like if you want to make a snowball, you're going to have to apply consistent pressure to the reaction mixture, and it's going to be hissing and spluttering like mad. So let's do it! Here we go! So as you can see, it's going to start smoking a lot the second the dry ice gets into that mixture. The second that you have done this, you need to remove the plastic bag from the bowl, lift it upwards, getting all of the mixture down to the bottom, and as you can see, this is smoking like mad at the moment. Now, we need to be applying pressure consistently to the bottom. And you might want, and if you have a lab coat, it might be worth wearing it just so it doesn't splutter all over you. So I'm just forcing it gradually down to the bottom, and then I will clutch it together with my hands, applying pressure to make all of the different fragments of dry ice that we have here gradually coagulate into one fragment, which will be our comet nucleus. Yep, keep forcing it, here we go. As you can see, it will start to drip, that's absolutely fine, and just keep doing this until just about all of the liquid in the bottom has boiled away. Alright, here we go. I can definitely feel the nucleus forming now. Should take around just about a minute or so for the reaction to be completed. And it's moving on quite nicely at the moment. We're nearly done. Okay, I think we're done. Let's take a look at what we've made. So we gently remove it from the bag into the bowl. And here we are! One comet for you! Ha! Fantastic! Now you can really hear it just hissing and bubbling at you. And that's because in the hot environment of our room, it's simulating what happens when a comet approaches the sun, where it heats up and all of the trapped and frozen gases within it start to emerge and then evaporate. And it's that hissing that will start to form the tail of the comet, which is what we always associate with it. Now, there are plenty more mysteries to learn about comets. As you can see here, it's pretty much spherical. And as we know, Comet 67P looks a lot more like a rubber duck, for example. So there's a lot more that we still have to learn about these mysterious objects. Anyway, until next time, signing off.